Well, here we go again. Hi there, Sanctuary Support Line. How can I help you? Yes? Hello? Is he... Oh, God! Oh, I guess it's one of those times! Oh, no! Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Limbo Line. This is a game where you play as a support center operator, and you're supposed to help people across multiverse. So, hey, let's get right into it, shall we?
You've reached Sanctuary Support Line. How can I help you?
New recruit induction. Status. Pending. Here at SSL, you will find fulfillment in helping others. However, support work is a difficult job, and sometimes you may be faced with upsetting, disturbing situations. Employees of SSL are advised to pay attention to the following hazards while working at the office. Bad language. Threatening behavior. References to self-harm and suicide. References to abortion. Mild sexual references. Depictions of blood. Disturbing sounds. Mild flashing lights. Possible jump scares. Energy demons and other foul entities. Loss of life, literally and figuratively. If you feel unsure about any of the above, please consider carefully if work at SSL is the right choice for you. To provide our clients with the best possible experience, employees of SSL should wear headphones or alternative appropriate listening devices while in the office. New recruit induction status complete. I can't believe it's been a whole year already. So this is where it happened, huh? This is the last thing you saw before you went and threw it all away? It's hardly scenic up here, is it? Easing down the roaring traffic far beneath me, a bustling blur of pointlessness, I finally feel the weight of my own significance in the world. It's difficult not to imagine you thinking the same. Is that why you did it? Ah, idiot. Why didn't you just talk to me? You could have picked up the damn phone and given me a call. I thought we had each other's backs, no matter what. Did you even spare a single thought for me? For how I might feel? We were supposed to be best friends, dammit! Is there honestly nothing left in your life worth living for? What about me? You just left me behind. Alone. If I make the same choice you did, will I get to see you again, Maddie? I'm gonna go home. There's no way I'm jumping. No. I won't do it. Not you. You always loved Halloween more than me, right? Well, guess what? I'm gonna have the most incredible Halloween party this year. I'm giving you the opportunity to finally prove to me that afterlife exists. Believe in ghosts. Show me the proof that it actually exists. Please, come find me later. Incident Report 01, Lonely Dance. Our protagonist had the most amazing Halloween party, but no paranormal entity showed up. Wait, what? Wait, was that an ending? Wait, that was an ending. What? Wait. So I was supposed to jump. All right, we jump. I probably shouldn't. It is tempting, though, to feel what you did, to know for certain what's on the other side.
I'll show.
What? Huh? Okay. Whee! Also, I'm gonna lower the music just a little bit. What was that? No, I'm falling! Someone! Anyone! Please! Help! Where am I? What is this place?
Ah, are you the newest recruit? Welcome. You're going to have an absolute blast here, trust me.
What do you mean by the newest recruit? Why are you hot? Almost jumping right out of my skin, I glance around the room in a state of panic, eyes darting between the serpentine creature in front of me and its seemingly erroneous surroundings. Welcome to where exactly? Releasing a sharp hiss of irritation, the creature closes in, forcing me to retreat sheepishly.
I do wish you folks would stop asking me that for once, and perhaps pay a compliment to my hair, or something instead.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of hard to do so. I mean, your hair was beautiful. I love your hair.
Do you have any idea how long I spend each morning making myself presentable for you people?
You people? What are you even talking about, my dude?
No, of course you don't. You don't give a damn about my appearance, do you? Selfish is what that is. I honestly don't know why I bother.
Well, yeah, you're right. Appearances don't matter for me. I was still Smash. Sheesh. Touchy much? I will apologize, O'Hare. Apologize, hair. Apologize, hair. Let's talk about the hair, shall we? You have hair? Wait! Wait, no! That's not what I meant! No! I can't roll back!
Why, you little... What are you, blind as well as selfish? Look! Here!
Yeah, I can see your hair! It's beautiful! Gesturing madly to the strange smoky substance whirling bewitchingly around its head, the snake scowls at me at irritation. I want to go back! Alright, I'm gonna apologize. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to offend you or anything.
No, you're not. But whatever. If you compliment me, all will be forgiven.
Look, you're hot! What is wrong with the strange snake?
I'm sorry, did I stutter? Give me a compliment now!
Oh, aren't you a good snakey, stinky friend? Ooh, oh. Your scales look so incredibly shiny. Why am I doing this?
Oh, you're such a dear. If only everyone that passed through this place was as wonderful as you.
Honestly, like you're the most wonderful thing I've seen so far. Ooh, ooh. I feel lightheaded all of a sudden, as though something just sucked away my energy. Forcing my back up against the wall, the creature flicks its tongue at me, tasting the air around my face.
Are you bothering the new employees again, Nyarn? Honestly, when will you learn? No one's foolish enough to compliment you, you disgusting leech.
My god, everyone here is hot! Yes! Boo, I did!
Well, that's where you're wrong, Aki, my dear. This one said my scales were absolutely gleaming with luster.
You're absolutely gleaming with lust. Ooh, yes. That's not quite how I put it.
Is that true? You actually paid this wretch a compliment?
Yeah, like, you got a problem with that? Yeah, but just a small one.
Then I stand corrected. I'm not sure we require someone of your stupidity to assist us, but alas, we're stuck with you for the time being. Do you feel weak by any chance?
I do, actually. I do. I thought this entity had arrived on the scene to save me from a snake, but his biting tone is almost as concerning. A little. Why?
Nyarn is an energy demon, one who drains the life of others who pay it any sort of attention, especially in the form of compliments.
Oh. Well, I'm gonna call him a good boy all I want. I don't care. He can suck anything out of me. Oh, no. Demon. That explains the scales, I guess. So, does that mean I'm in hell, then? I know I haven't led the humblest life, but I can't say I saw myself ending up here.
Everyone's gotta eat, right? Stop demonizing me for being myself.
Yeah, exactly. Tell him, Nyarn.
For once in your agonizingly long life, would you just be quiet?
Oh man, I freaking love Akaros and Nyarn already.
You're the true monster here, Aki. Freaking killjoy extraordinaire. It's almost as if you want me to starve.
No, I want you. Well, I wouldn't want you to starve. I mean, I won't mind if you get thirsty, though.
You'll certainly be doing us all a favor.
Oh, man.
Why don't you tell this one what you do to folks like them, huh?
Oh, what does Aki do?
You've probably stood there thinking, oh, Aki here is your new best friend. Oh, no. Nope. Your jailer. More like.
Well, if that's what Aki's into.
Silence! Unless you want to add another year to your service.
Oh no! Visibly shuddering at the entity's apparent threat, Neart shrinks backwards, hissing defensively.
I can only apologize for such a horrific welcome party. I'm normally here right on time to greet new guests. Please, just ignore this foul creature and come with me.
Well, I'll come wherever you'd like.
Your words no longer faze me, barbarian. Good luck, newbie. You're sure gonna need it.
All right. Feeling as though I had no other choice, I followed behind the administrator, dragging my heels as I watched Neart slink away towards another room.
All right. Now that we're free of that detestable nuisance, we can begin. Let's get you registered, shall we? Name, please?
Before I even have the chance to ask a single question, the administrator glares at me, sending me a slight shudder down my spine. I wish I knew what the heck I'm supposed to be signing up for here. For that matter, I wish I could actually remember my name. General Turdbucket? Oh my god, am I actually gonna go with General Turdbucket? Yeah, why not? I'll go with General Turdbucket.
Do you truly expect me to believe that's your name? Either your poor attempt at humor has failed miserably, or your parents had despicable taste. Which is it?
Sorry, I misspoke. It won't happen again.
It better not, if you know what's good for you, newbie. If that's the sort of thing you find amusing, you and I are going to have problems.
Whoa, what, like liquids getting all up in your circuit boards? I don't know my name!
Very well, we shall refer to you as Nine, since that's the booth you'll most likely be taking over.
I like the name. Nine sounds good. Great, now I'm reduced to a mere number.
So, Nine, which do you find more soothing? Feminine voices or masculine voices?
Wait, for myself or for you? What kind of question is that? Why? I'm confused. What's that got to do with anything?
Your manager has the ability to alter their voice to best suit each of their volunteers. We understand how frightening this situation can be for you new recruits. And so we do our best to make things as comfortable as possible for you while you settle into your new routine.
Well, that's nasty. But I still don't even know why I'm here or where here even is.
Ah. All in due time, my friend. Further questions may be asked once your operator profile is complete. Patience is a virtue and all that nonsense.
Well, I guess I could go for a feminine voice? I have no idea. I don't know. Let's go for femme.
Alright, noted. Finally, a word of warning. Office romances are strictly forbidden. We must remain professional at all times. That also means no sharing of client personal information or our company's location data. Clear?
Yeah, that's very clear to me. Give me a firm nod of acknowledgement. I find the compulsion to blurt out the questions on the tip of my tongue, opting instead to cling onto the hope that he'll grant me permission to ask them.
Very good. That should be everything we need from you for the moment. Do you have any questions before I hand you over to get set up?
Okay. Where am I? It would be nice to have some idea as to where I even am right now. Last thing I remember is falling, then I ended up here.
Your arrival in this place is no coincidence. When you decided to jump from that building, you chose to change your life.
Okay. But I didn't jump. I was pushed.
Details, details.
God damn it. To you, maybe.
The fact of the matter is, instead of falling to your death, you entered a space most commonly known as Limbo. A place between worlds where you wait for your fate to be decided, neither living nor dead.
Okay.
A word of warning, though. You can still feel physical pain, and should you sustain a grave injury of any sort, we'll be unable to return you to your previous life.
Oh, straight up yikes. But how is that even possible? The administrator sighs as though the answer to my question should somehow be obvious.
So you know nothing of the supernatural world? Think about the date for a moment. Surely you must have heard how thin the veil between dimensions is coming up to Hallow's Eve.
I didn't know that was a thing. I guess.
Under normal circumstances, an entity can enter Limbo if their desire is strong enough. However, around Hallow's Eve, all it takes is a mere drop.
Straight up, yikes! Whoa!
Someone here sensed your desire and brought you here to serve your sentence.
Okay, that seems reasonable. You make it sound as though I'm in prison here, am I?
In the sense that you may not leave until your sentence is served, yes. But I assure you, this is no punishment. Merely a test of your ability to aid others.
Okay, sounds lovely.
If that is all, we really should be getting on. Our work here is never done.
All right, onwards to work. Oh, wait, I gotta know what's my job. You never did explain exactly what I'm supposed to be doing here.
During your time here in Limbo, you will be assessed by a manager. Said manager will weigh in on which realm you should inhabit once your time with us in Limbo is up.
Okay.
You will deal with support requests from various dimensions. It is your job to listen and provide friendly, helpful, unbiased advice.
All right, sounds good. Like a support line.
Precisely. Limbo is actually just a collection of offices on Earth, capable of taking calls from all manner of places.
Oh, so that's how Befrienders is able to deal with the huge volume. Then it's more like listening to prayers and stuff.
Excuse me. Would you assume our job is to play God? This isn't even remotely the same. We take the utmost pride in our work here.
Yeah, it sounds like we actually get our job done.
What we do is arguably even more important than those lazy angels dilly-dallying about delivering messages to the Almighty One. No, we are the backbone of the operation. Things keep running because of the work we do here at Limbo. If you even dare to compare our efforts to that of those winged, work-shy cretins, I shall have you sanctioned for insulting our honor.
So I get it. We do the actual important work here rather than, just waiting for people to give up their souls. Got it. Sorry.
Apology accepted. Was there anything else you wanted to ask?
Yeah, if we're on Earth, can I go home once I'm done with my shift?
I'm afraid you may be misunderstanding your situation, Nine. You cannot leave Limbo while undergoing assessment.
I see, yeah, that's...
Think of your time with us as a sort of indentured servitude, if you will. Your reward being a second chance at life, be that here on Earth or in another realm.
Yeah, that sounds like an internship.
If that is all, we really should be getting on. Our work here is never done.
Well, I got more questions. How long will I be here? How long do I have to stay here, anyway?
3 days is usually long enough for a manager to make their judgment. But in some cases, it can take up to a year before a volunteer moves on to their suited realm.
Suited realm? There's more than just Earth? Cool. A whole year.
Well, you could always attempt to leave if it gets to be too much, but I urge you not to. The mess alone would take eons to clean. Just thinking about the stains our last runner left behind gives me nightmares.
What happened there? Well, that's disturbing. So that I can still die while I'm here.
Oh, yes. You're still quite mortal, I'm afraid. And that weak human form of yours is ever so prone to damage, so please endeavor to keep yourself safe. The nursing department is already understaffed as it is. They scarcely need any trouble from the likes of you.
Sounds fair. Sounds
if
fair.
If that is all, we really should be getting on. Our work here is never done.
Wait. I still got one more question. What's with your head? I don't mean to be rude, but why is your head like that? Were you in some kind of accident?
I don't mean to be rude either, but why does your face resemble that of a smacked bottom? Did you sustain some sort of horrific injury and undergo facial reconstruction? Or were you simply born that way?
Straight up yikes! Ow! Point taken.
If that is all, we really should be getting on. Our work here is never done.
Alright, let's all. Let's go.
Then allow me to escort you to your manager, so you can get started.
Is my manager hot too? That's my last question, I swear. Can I smash everyone here? Without further delay, the administrator beckons me to follow, and I trail behind him, still glancing disbelievingly at my surroundings in a mixture of awe and confusion.
Yo.
I listen to the droning of ringing phones, my eyes settling on an empty desk space and the occupant opposite. Are those cat ears? Spinning around with a sigh, the creature shuffles towards the vacant desk in irritation. But before she can make it there, the phone ringing ceases and she casually flips a claw hand over her shoulder, wheeling herself back to her booth.
Keel! Remind me again, are we allowed to call him back?
My god, she's cute!
For the 100th time, Nyari. No.
Whoa, hello there, Keel.
Well, then we need to get someone on 9. I can't man 2 different freaking stations, you know.
I'm aware of that. Thank you.
You're right.
Allow
hi there.
Allow me to hand you over to your manager. Keel, this is our newest volunteer, 9.
Hi there.
Aptly named. I assume that was your doing. Thank you kindly, Administrator. You may leave 9 in my hands. I'm sure you have plenty of work to be getting on with.
As do we all. Please keep a close eye on this one.
But it's not like I'm going to cause any trouble.
Indeed.
All right.
Then this is where we part ways, 9. It has been a pleasure to be your guide. I hope you enjoy your time here with us in Limbo.
Oh, I sure will. With a curt bow, the administrator swiftly turns on his heels, flicking his tail as he exits the room.
Oh, don't mind old metalhead there. He can be pretty harsh, but he gets the job done efficiently. Allow me to give you a proper welcome to our humble department.
Thank you, Keel. Wait, what? Did she kiss me? Oh, God. A kind smile adorns the manager's face as Keel plants a soft kiss on the back of my hand. Though it does little to calm my nerves at this bizarre situation, I got kissed by my manager.
I'm going to place you here, opposite Nyari. I'm assuming you two haven't met?
No, we haven't. Hi, Nyari. Staring at the creature in front of me, fluffy ears twitching away. I'm pretty sure I'd remember seeing someone like this. Pleased to meet you. I don't think so. Hi, I'm 9 apparently.
Welcome, welcome. I'm Nyari, the one and only. I'm sure you're pretty nervous since it's your first day, but don't worry, we don't bite. At least, not most of us anyways.
Can you direct me to the ones who will bite?
Nyari.
What?
What? It's true. Watch your back around, Keel, newbie. That pretty face hides a very grumpy little gremlin.
Oh, no.
I can hear you, Nyari.
Well, indeed, we all can.
I know. You're supposed to.
Oh, my God.
Anyways, old Keel's given you prime location there.
Yeah, I get to be close with Nyari. Really? Is that good?
Meh. Depends.
What do you mean, depends? Nyari's slight shrug of apathy doesn't exactly fill me with confidence as Keel gestures to the chair in front of the booth.
This was Maddie's booth. She was one of our longest-serving volunteers, but she had to take some compassionate leave.
Wait, Maddie? Wait, surely it can't be the same person. There's no way. I guess this isn't really the time to ask. I need to pay attention before I wind up in trouble.
She, had 3 dead dads in 2 days. And it kind of tipped the poor gal over the edge.
What do you mean 3 dead dads? Oh, overcall. I see. I suppose that would be a lot for anyone to handle, especially if you just sat here unable to do anything about it.
That was probably her phoning in a minute ago.
Oh, God.
Yes, and if it was, we'd have respected her confidentiality, wouldn't we, Nyari?
Yeah, Nyari.
Of course we would, Commander Keel.
Rolling her eyes at Keel, Nyari mimes shooting herself in the head, causing me to stifle a chuckle.
Right. Let's get you settled in then, shall we?
Yeah, let's. My god, everyone here is cute. Lowering myself gently onto the chair provided, I couldn't help but wonder why the setup looks so basic. The desk phone, which seems awfully outdated, and a bland monitor. The dividers on either side of the booth seem somewhat pointless, considering your neighbors must be able to hear you talking on the phone anyhow.
As you can see, it's compact and cozy, with a south-facing view and ensuite facilities.
Ooh, thank you, Keel. Leaning over the monitor, all I can see is a wall with windows painted shut.
Don't worry, newbie. I didn't laugh either.
Keel pauses and scowls at Nyari before taking a seat and returning attention to me.
Obviously, you haven't been properly inducted, but you have absolutely nothing to worry about. I'll be right here by your side for your first few calls until you get the hang of things.
Oh, thank you, Keel.
No. When a call comes through, we like to answer as soon as possible and begin every dialogue with, "Hello, Sanctuary Support Line."
Well, that seems all right. Sure thing. Okay. I think I can handle that.
I also don't mind anyone using the abbreviation SSL, because Sanctuary Support Line does sound a bit like an animal shelter.
Yeah, it does.
Somewhere you keep threatening to send folks like me, huh, Kial? Xenophobic asshole.
Oh my god, Niari!
Ignore her. Now, whatever the caller wants to talk about, we offer active listening. Though, about one in every five calls will just be silent.
I see. Alright. Because they're plucking up the courage, right?
Yes, you just have to make sure they're not, plucking something else.
What do you mean, plucking something else? Is the manager seriously suggesting what I'm thinking? You don't mean, oh god, having self-adult fun times?
Sadly, yes. It has become a bit of an epidemic.
I see. All right. Wonderful. That's just what I needed in my life. How will I be able to tell the difference? Before Kiel has an opportunity to answer, a mildly disturbing sound comes sloshing from the booth behind me, and I turn to witness Niari creating a slapping sound with her cheeks.
Niari, that is quite enough.
Yes, it is. Oh my god, Niari. Turning back to her desk with a giggle, I try my best not to laugh with her, Kiel's stoic glare piercing my shoulder.
Your ear soon becomes attuned.
Oh god! I'm gonna get used to the splooshies! Now! Okay, gotcha, boss! Oh god.
Now, you might find you have a dead hour or so when no one contacts you. I don't mind you using that time to read a novel or browse the net for news, even puzzle games are fine, but I do frown upon people watching box sets during their downtime.
What, you mean anime? Box sets.
It was the season finale! Leave me alone!
Oh man, Niari. Catching another chuckle before it leaves my mouth, I clench my fist, the thought of Niari's ears twitching away in excitement while watching the drama unfold filling my mind.
The point is, you have to be focused and ready to go at a moment's notice.
I see. Alright. What if I don't speak the language, though?
Not a problem. Our systems may seem a little outdated, but we do have a multiversal translator at our disposal. Everything you hear will be translated for you to understand, and every word you speak will be translated in turn.
Whoa, that's so cool. Alright. Oh, looks like I got a call.
There you go. Do you want to just jump straight in?
Yeah, sure. Let's go. All right. Let's go. Take a deep breath. A hand hovers over the phone as manager Kiel prepares to listen in via earpiece. Hello, Sanctuary, SSL line. How can I help you? Nerves getting the better of me, I managed to fluff the opener.
Hi. This is an important message regarding your recent insurance policy. In order to process your refund...
Oh my god.
Hang up.
Okay, hang up. Is it okay to just terminate the dialogue?
Well, that's not a dialogue, is it? We'll have to get something done about this. There are more of these ridiculous scams going around than wankers.
Oh, dear.
I'm going to speak to admin about this, see if we can filter some out. You sit tight. Niari will help you if needed.
All right, see you, Kiel. Without giving me the chance to raise a question... Kiel curtly rises from his seat beside me, storming off in a huff. As Kiel leaves, someone I don't yet recognize enters, and I crane my neck to try to get a better view.
Don't even go there.
What? What's up? No, I was just trying to work out who everyone is. Wheeling herself close to me, Niari leans in, lowering her voice so as not to be overheard.
That right there is Tava Trueglacier, which is appropriate because they're colder than a witch's tit.
Oh no! They?
Mm-hmm. Tav is some kind of super symbiote or something. Lots of entities all sharing one host. None of them with even a hint of warmth. You'd get more compassion from an answer phone.
Man! Oh, you're cold. Ow!
Two words for ya, newbie. Avoid.
Well, just like their heart, I'm guessing. Alright. I'm sure poor Tava can't be that bad. Right, noted. So have you been volunteering here long? Uncomfortable with the idea of talking about a colleague behind their back, I try to move the conversation on.
Me? Well, I was brought in for a 2-week stint about 5 years ago. I just got kinda addicted to it.
Oh, really?
They let you stay here, you know, if that's what you want at the end of your trial. Ooh. And if you're not being sentenced elsewhere, of course. What about you?
Well, I was mourning my friend and then I sort of just ended up here. I always wanted to try volunteering someplace like this, though, when I was feeling really lost. I wish I had someone to... Well...
Hey! Sanctuary Support Line! How can I help you?
Talk to. Heaving a sigh, I turn away from Niari, staring blankly at the screen in front of me. When a ringing disturbs my train of thought, sending me into a slight panic. Manager Keel, got another call! Glancing back at Niari, I can see she's already in the middle of a genuine call, so I hope Keel heard my desperate cry for help. Oh, gosh. Oh, there you are! Appearing in a heartbeat, Keel clambers into the chair beside me, throwing on the headset with a haste.
Okay, remember, no leading, no counseling, just active listening. Go.
All right, here we go. Nodding in acknowledgement, I pick up the phone. Hello, SSL. Eyes narrow. I shoot my manager a sideways glance of concern, wondering if this is one of those infamous self-enjoyers I was warned about earlier. Holding up a hand and still telling me to hang on, Kiel's head shakes tentatively from side to side as I sit there, unsettled by the suspicious sounds in my ear. Do you want to talk to someone?
Oh goodness. Well, a couple of years ago, there was an incident.
I see. Right.
Oh, girl. After the incident, I was pretty depressed, obviously. But I did manage to get back on track, even though it was quite a serious incident.
What happened? I see.
And as they told me at the clinic, with that kind of incident, you're not going to bounce back overnight, are you? It takes its toll, okay? But I can't sleep now, because I always thinking about that dumbass incident.
Gosh darn, sounds like you're going through a really rough time, my dude. Why do they keep repeating the incident instead of just telling me what happened?
Pearl, I'll be having nightmares about it. And all I can think when I wake up is, fuck, the incident this, the incident that. Girl can't get no fucking peace.
What was the incident?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Okay. So without revealing to me the nature of the incident...
It's not a magic trick.
Sorry. I suck at this, but I don't know what else I'm supposed to say.
It was an abortion, if you must know.
Right. I see. Well, that was your choice.
I know it was!
No, I mean, that was your choice to tell me. I didn't force it out of you. Pooh. That went well. Sarcasm is all I have left to defend myself with after that shockingly dreadful performance.
Don't beat yourself up too much. That was good. I'm just glad you didn't say anything about terminating the call.
Yeah. Unsure as to whether that was supposed to be another one of Kiel's jokes, I sit there with a slightly awkward half grin on my face.
You're going to be just fine.
Thank you, Kiel. I wouldn't be so sure about that. Was Kiel actually listening to the same conversation a second ago?
Now, I need to get on with some of my other duties, so I'll leave you to it. Just keep doing what you're doing and give me a shout if you need any assistance.
Thank you, Kiel. Well, part of me wants to ask Kiel to stay, but my lips remain sealed. I'm sure not every interaction will end in disaster. At least I certainly hope that's not the case. Alright, spinning on my chair to see how Niari's getting on, I listen in on her conversation.
Yeah. Yeah? Oh my, did he? Yeah, well, I would say if it's brown, take it straight back.
Wait, what? Oh god, what the heck is that all about? I guess it's none of my business. I need to concentrate on my station. He'll still have to be ready at a moment's notice after all. Just as I'm debating whether or not to get some coffee, my phone rings once more. Already? I suppose I should answer. Hello there, this is SSL. How can I help you?
Hi. So sorry to bother you. I just... feel so stupid, and I was hoping you might be able to help me.
Sure, yeah. That's what I'm here for. What's up?
Well, I'm a witch, you see. And witches are supposed to have familiars, right? My name's Tabitha, by the way.
Ah, nice to meet you, Tabby. It's nice to meet you, Tabitha. And sure, I guess. So I'm just talking to an actual witch now. That's totally normal.
The problem is, I'm scared of animals, especially cats. They really creep me out. But everyone at school makes fun of me because I'm the only one who doesn't have a familiar.
Oh, geez, that is rough. Well, hey, well, listen. I will just listen. All right, active listening. Here we go.
I think it's because my dad used to run a zoo. And when I was little, my brother shut me inside overnight.
Oh my god, that is mean. That's awful, Tabitha. I'm so sorry you had to go through that. Your brother sounds super mean.
Come to think of it, maybe it's not the animals that I'm truly afraid of after all. I think I might be able to figure something out. Thanks so much for talking to me.
Aw, you're welcome. And that's that, I guess. Swinging my legs beneath the desk, I anxiously await the next denizen in distress. When I suddenly realize Neri isn't at her post. In fact, the office has gotten awfully quiet. Maybe it's break time or something? What should I do next? Huh. I guess I will talk to a colleague. Let's see if I can find anyone. Who should I look for? Akros, Neri, or Akil. I'm gonna talk to Neri. I like the cat girl. Neri! Wonder what Neri's up to. What's up, Neri?
Newbie! Hey! I was gonna ask if you wanted to join me, but I was in such a rush to make sure they weren't out of my favorite that I kinda forgot. Sorry about that.
Aw, don't worry about it, Neri. You can't do me any wrong. No worries. I just wonder where everyone else had gone. It got so quiet all of a sudden. Kiel didn't even bother to ask me if I was allowed a proper break.
Of course not. Because the old creep would want to keep you tied to that damn desk. We all get breaks here. The calls are just forwarded to another office if no one's there to answer.
I see. You seem to be well informed, Neri. What do you know about the manager?
Someone's observant, huh? Thanks. Now, let me see. Kiel. There was this rumor going around a while back that the manager was actually appointed to that position as punishment, rather than rising through the ranks.
Really? Huh. Seems like a strange punishment. What did Kiel do?
Beats me. But think of a name for a second. What's Kiel an anagram of?
Loki?
See my point?
What's it an anagram of? Okay, Lee? So, what's this favorite food of yours that you were in such a hurry for?
Fishbone soup.
Fishbone soup? Huh. That doesn't sound so good. Is it Kilo?
Well, I'll have you know, it's the best. You should try it sometime.
Alright, I might just try it. Heck, I think I'll pass. Fishbone soup sounds lovely. What the heck? That'll be a good idea. Alright, we're back here. Oh, I'm on camera. Okay, for some reason, the screen froze right then. So I'm gonna try something else. Maybe, let's try talking to Kiel instead. Let's see where that goes. All right. I guess I should get to know the manager better. Manager Kiel, can I please sit with you?
Of course. Come.
Thanks.
It's tough being the newbie, right? How are you finding things? Settling in okay?
Yeah, I am. You and Neri have been a huge help.
Neri certainly has a talent for talking, though that's not always a good thing in her case.
Really? I thought that would make her pretty much perfect for this job.
Then you've clearly already forgotten what I taught you earlier, Nine.
What do you mean by that?
Listen, not to spout nonsense at our callers, as Neri so often does. It's a wonder half of them don't hang up after 5 minutes of listening to her incessant drivel.
Oh my god. She seems sweet, though.
Yes, well, sweet is a far cry from silent. Something which would make her far more suitable. Please, Nine, whatever you do, don't make her your role model. The last thing we need here is another charming chatterbox.
But I am a charming chatterbox. Yeah, I guess I'll agree. Right, noted. So if you don't mind me asking, how long have you been working here?
Too long.
What do you mean by too long? Let's see. You like it here? I'll take it that's a no.
When you've been around this place for as long as I have, you tend to just become immune to it all. Aside from that, I have to answer to the admin. You wouldn't believe the sheer stress of it all.
Oh gosh, I can imagine, Keol. I guess it would be pretty stressful being in charge of something so important.
Important? Hardly.
What do you mean? But Administrator Akaros said...
Ashros says a lot of things, and he's a creature who takes great pride in his work.
I see.
I, on the other hand, would rather be sat at home, in a bubble bath, roses all around me, and drinking a lovely glass of wine, if you catch my meaning.
Yeah, I kind of get it. Kind of sounds like you need a holiday. Must be working you to the bone.
You could say that again, but a job's a job. I suppose I shouldn't complain.
Hell yeah. I mean, you have every right to. When you're tasked with listening to other people's problems all day long, the least you're entitled to is a bit of a moan yourself.
You know what? You are absolutely right there, Nine. I think I'm starting to like you.
Ah, well, you can like me all you want, Keol. Does that mean you didn't before?
Play fair now, Nine. You're twisting my words. Don't forget, I'm your manager.
Okay. Like, we'll play fair here. Sorry.
I'm just kidding, Nine. Lighten up a little. Tell you what, why don't we meet again like this? The office is so cramped and suffocating, and it's been such a refreshing experience talking with you.
Aw, thanks, Keol. Sure, sounds good to me.
Then I believe we should get back to it. No rest for the wicked, as they say.
Yeah, all right, let's get to it. Let's go. What should I do next? Oh, Well, I guess I'll use the PC. Alright. Oh, wow. What's a wishmaker?
Welcome back. Changed your mind about my offer, huh?
Wait, what? Huh?
Oh, a new face. How cool. Allow me to congratulate you. You have one wish remaining, so choose wisely, brave hero.
One new wish? Sorry, I'm confused. Is this a game or are you living in my computer?
Life is a game, my friend. The real question is, are you the player or the puppet?
That doesn't answer my question, and you're mysteriously hot. Are you secretly like a shark person?
I tell you, you've got a wish to make, and you're sitting there wondering what it's all about? What's wrong with you? Most people would be super happy to find out they'd scored free wishes.
I guess I am. Well, I'm new here. I didn't even know wishes were a thing outside of fairy tales.
Wow, okay. Then you have a lot to learn. I'm guessing that means you know nothing of us djinn either, then.
Well, I kind of do. You'll have to enlighten me.
It would be my pleasure. The name's Gina. We djinn are a noble class of wish granters, bound by the fabric of the universe to create whimsy and wonder wherever we go. Those who are lucky enough to chance upon a djinn become the bearer of such wonderful wishes, which is where you come in.
So I'm a wish bearer now just because I'm using this computer. Also, I was just saying, that's a lie. That's a freaking lie. Just don't listen to... Look, djinns will always twist your wishes, like, in one way or another. Jesus.
Yep, that's how it works. Whoever finds me gets to use my wishes, and as I said, you have one wish remaining. So, if you could hurry up and think of something, that would be great.
Oh, man. Let's see. I'll make a wish. What harm could it do, except for all of it? In that case, could you please get me out? Oh no. I was brought here against my will, and I have no idea how long I'm gonna be stuck serving my sentence.
Easy peasy.
Oh, God.
This gift upon you I bestow. The final wish that you are owed. Releasing from false abode means... Foolish human, now you explode!
Wait!
I'm finally free. The air tastes so damn good out here. I can't believe that idiot made such a stupid request. What kind of a moron doesn't know you have to be specific when it comes to wishes? Now, time to get out of here without getting caught this time.
Oh. Oh no. Oh dear. Oh. Oh.
Incident report 6. Be careful what you wish for. God damn it. The plan to leave Limbo backfired and 9 was wished out of existence accidentally. I'm just gonna go ahead and talk to Akaros as well. Like, just see how that goes. Alright, here we go. Yo, Robo Dude! I guess it's not in here. Huh.
Well, well, well. Look who we have here. Just the snack I was hoping to find. You know, newbie, the cafeteria serves nothing for my kind. Nothing!
Oh, I'ma feed you real good, Nyard. Why, if it isn't the resident Bellend.
What did you just call me, human? It better have been a compliment.
Oh, sure, sure. It was definitely a compliment. Don't worry about it, Nyard. Yeah, where I come from, that's one of the nicest things you could call someone. I'd say that to all my friends.
Friends? Hmm? Then, Nyard is your friend too, yes?
Yes, and friends feed each other, Sure, why not?
Excellent! Before long, I'll be the biggest Bellend in your life, newbie.
What does Bellend even mean? Hold on, I'm just gonna like Google this. Apparently it means annoying or contemptible men, so that's that. It also means like the glands of the penis. Oh
hey,
gosh.
Shoo! Shoo! Quit bothering the newbie before I step on your stupid tail.
But you also have a tail. People could step on yours too.
Ugh, my tail is far more fabulous than yours will ever be, darling. You look like a giant hairy rat.
She's a giant hairy cat. What you talking about?
Whatever, snake. Beat it, or I'll peel all your scales off one by one until you're just a leathery little worm.
Man, I love Nyari. I love Nyari.
Vulgar. Fine. I'll find someone to snack on someplace where the air doesn't smell like soiled kitty litter.
Nyar, don't do Nyari dirty like that, no!
You shouldn't let that oddball push you around like that, newbie. You gotta stick up for yourself, or you'll wind up in some pretty sticky situations.
Oh, I won't mind getting to some really sticky situations. I will nod. Instead of offering a response, I simply nod my head in agreement. Nyari, have you seen the admin around at all?
Nope. At least, not recently anyways. He doesn't often visit these parts unless a newbie like yourself needs escorting. Was there something you needed? Maybe I can help.
Not really. Eh, right. Don't worry about it. I just thought you might be able to help me find someone is all.
Oh, well, there's probably not enough time now. But if you head straight to reception on your next break, you might be able to catch him there.
Oh, sure. Alright, cool. I might just do that. Thanks, Nyari.
No problem, newbie. Catch you later.
Alright, see ya. Man, I like Nyari. I really like Nyari. And back to my desk we go. What should I do next? I guess I'll just wait. No point trying to leave. Later that day. Well, here we go again. Hi there, Sanctuary Support Line. How can I help you? Yes? Hello? Is he? Oh god! Oh, I guess it's one of those times! Oh no! Please not again. Please not again. Hey, this is SSL. Can I help you today?
You probably can't. But I just need to vent to someone about my wife.
Yeah, sure. What up? All right, I'm listening. Go ahead.
Well, we recently went away on a holiday, and it's not like it was a bad holiday, you know? It was decent and all.
Yeah, I hear you. I'm sensing a possible butt here.
We went out for some nice meals. The hotel was clean. Plenty of luxury swamps nearby. I actually got a pretty good deal. One of those ones where you collect all the coupons.
Ooh, it sounds lovely. Or not. Uh-huh. Wait, did you say luxury swamps?
So yeah, like, she seemed happy with it all at the time. But then the weather kind of sucked, so there was a lot of sitting in cafes, which definitely didn't help.
Mm-hmm. All right. No, of course.
And it just sort of makes you realize you've got nothing to say to each other anymore. But I mean, I still got loads to talk about. It's more like it's coming from her, you know?
I see. Stifling a yawn, I glance around the office to see if anyone else is as bored as I am right now.
I mean, I tried to start conversations, but they'd just be one-word answers. Like, yes, or dunno.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yes.
I felt like she wasn't really interested in what I had to say. You know what I mean, right?
Oh yeah, I get exactly what you mean. I'm still kind of stuck on the luxury swamp sting, if I'm honest. It's hard to concentrate on his words of images of alligators on holiday in my head. Oh, God, I will just listen.
Anyway, I better head off. I've just heard her come back. But thanks very much. You've really helped me out.
Yeah, no worries. Yeah. Oh, good. Well, that's why we're here. Nice talking to you.
Bye. Darling, is that you?
I'm glad that's over.
I bet that's a relief.
Wait, why is there someone with a mask? Hi. Almost jumping on my skin, I turned to find myself face to massive Teyva. Huh?
That call. It seemed like a rather dull one.
Ah, yeah, it was.
That can happen sometimes. You'll get used to it.
Yeah, thanks, Teyva. I was dying for him to finish. Not that I didn't want to hear what he had to say, it just... Yeah, some people's problems seem more serious than others. Sorry. I'm 9.
Teyva. Hi.
Nice to meet you, Teyva. Smiling sheepishly at Teyva, I twiddle my thumbs, unsure how to proceed with the conversation or even where to look while I'm talking to them.
Do you mind if I sit down for a second?
Yeah, sure. I want to see how cute you look. Smash. Alright, pulling up a chair, Teyva sits down beside me, a foreboding air about them.
Listen, I know you're new and please don't think I'm being patronizing. Patronize means to talk down to someone.
Yeah. Alright, right?
That was a joke, by the way.
Alright, I see, yeah. You could have fooled me. What is it with people and these terrible jokes in this place? Yeah, really good.
It's just, I've been a volunteer here for 3 years, and I always say the same thing to all the new recruits who walk through that door. Don't get involved.
Well, yeah, all I'm doing is just listening. I'm not really getting myself involved in anything. Yeah, sure. I wasn't planning to. I mean, you're not even my type, so... But Teyva is my type! What are you saying?
I don't mean with me. I mean with our clients.
Well, I mean, sure, yeah, I've got to keep, like, professional courtesy and all that. Right, yeah, Kiel told me that's not a good idea.
Exactly. It's not. These people are not your friends, in spite of what Nyari might say.
Yeah, I see. And Teyva, you're pretty cool, honestly. Yeah, she seems quite chatty.
She's probably been bitching about me behind my back already.
Yep, yeah, that's very true. Well, this is awkward.
Well, has she?
Not that I know of, no.
Well, let her. I don't care. I don't want any part of her pathetic little clique. Some of us have better things to do with our time than gossip all day long.
I hear you, Teyva. Yari is part of a clique. So true.
Just keep your guard up and your shutters down. Anyway, I'll let you get on with things.
Yeah, right. Thank you, Teyva. Thank you.
Good luck, 9.
Yeah, thanks. You're kind of hot, by the way. With a curt nod, Teyva walks away bristly. Nyari was a little off about them, sure. Teyva seems a bit odd, but certainly not an ice monster. Oh, yeah, another call. Oh, gosh. Hello, this is SSL. Can I help you with anything today? Is it one of those calls? Is it? I'm not sure if I even want to know what's supposed to be on the other end. Later that day. Oh, night. Alright. End of day one. Alright. Hello, Sanctuary Support Line. It's another one! Oh no! Okay.
Did you wanna? Hi? Hi, sir! I see you're having fun! Why do I even bother? For God's sake! Slamming the phone down in frustration, I lean back into my chair, holding my head in my hands.
Let me guess. Another masturbator? Filthy animals need to find a new fetish already, if you ask me. Right! I'm off. I've got a hot date with a tuna steak.
Wait, bring me with you! I want some tuna steak! Wait, you can leave?
Perks of loyal service, my friend. Stick at it, and maybe one day you'll reach my level. Enjoy the night shift, newbie.
Thanks, Nyari. Oh, God. I want to protest, but there's no time for me to make a fuss as the phone starts ringing once more. Gathering her things, Nyari mouths goodnight to me before shuffling out of the office, leaving me sat there by myself. Hello, SSL. Seriously? Again? What is with these people? Hello?
Is Maddie there?
Sorry, no. Maddie's not here tonight.
Aww.
Was there something you wanted to talk about?
What's your name?
I'm afraid we're advised not to give out our personal details.
Maddie did.
Well, she's no longer a volunteer here, but I am.
Okay.
You can tell me your name if you'd like.
Mallory.
Hi, Mallory. I'm here for you.
Will you talk to me?
Of course. What are you doing?
What do you want to talk about?
Well, you choose. Well, I'm just here to listen, so you tell me.
Well, I hate my life. I hate my mom. I hate my stepdad. Especially hate my stepdad. I haven't done anything with my life.
How old are you, Mallory?
24.
Well, there you are. Still very young. You got your whole life ahead of you.
Huh? Yeah.
Oh God, Mallory, no! Mallory, no! We were having a good thing! Mallory? Mallory, come on! Mallory, not into my ear! Oh, no! Listen, Mallory, I don't want to be rude, but if you're doing what I think you're doing, I'm gonna have to ask you to stop, because...
What? I've got stomach cramps.
Okay, stomach cramps. I gotcha. Panic over. Oh, okay, that's fine then. It's just that you're not allowed to...
I've taken some tablets.
Or not. Sorry?
I've taken some tablets.
Have you? Okay, do you know roughly how many?
30? Maybe 40?
Mallory, no! Mallory, no, my sweet boy! Right. Oh God, what the heck am I supposed to do now? There's no way I can help just sat at the stupid desk. No, to try and stay calm.
I just wanted someone to talk to before I go.
Oh, frick. Oh God damn it. Why did this have to happen now when there's no one to help? It's okay. Just follow procedure. Gazing down at my scribbled notes, I take a gulp of dry air. Well, I can do that, Mallory. I'm certainly gonna keep talking to you, but if you have a phone with you, you could also dial the relevant emergency number.
No.
If you call them, you can ask for an ambulance, or if you feel as though you can't, I can always call them for you.
No, please. Don't do that.
All right. I'm not gonna do that, Mallory. I promise. We'll just talk if that's what you want. I feel so helpless.
Thank you. It's so hot.
Yeah. Our windows are painted shut here, so you can't get any air in.
Well, that's a shame.
Mallory? Are you all right?
Will you sing to me?
Sure. I'm not very good at it, but I'll give it a go. What do you want to hear?
Well, I like a lot of ballads, but I think they might be a bit long. Do you know any children's rhymes or
lullabies.
You mean like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star?
Yeah.
Okay, I think I know most of it. Here we go. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. I'm not sure if there's more. There is. I don't know what it is. How was that, Mallory? My name's Nine, by the way. Staring straight at the eerie glow of the monitor in front of me, slowly placed the phone back to my desk, defeated. Was I truly helpful? Was that honestly enough just to listen? Before I can dwell on the harrowing call of Mallory for another second, my phone rings once again. All I can do is suck the stale office air into my lungs as I wipe away a lone tear. Hello, SSL.
I'm so sorry to bother you, dear, but I just couldn't sleep, you see. Baldrick died last week, and the house seems so empty without him.
I'm not sure if I can deal with this right now.
He was my cat, you see, and he meant the world to me.
My God.
Hello?
Yeah. I'm sorry to hear that.
It's not just me. Edmund misses him. And Melky. Oh, they were all from the same litter. I just miss his little paws padding about. He had such a lovely meow. 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 They all have very different personalities, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And Baldrick was such a softy, really. Heart of absolute gold. Although he did have his moments. Oh, he would often bring me little parcels from the garden. A mouse or a sparrow. And he would be quite adamant that I pick them up. But you're not supposed to encourage them, you see.
I see.
Anyway, I'm devastated, to be honest. I just don't see how I can go on now. There's such a hole without him. It's like this terrible ache.
I will be sympathetic. I know what that's like because I lost someone precious to me too. Maddie. I know it's hard right now, but trust me. Things will get better as time goes on. Only it didn't for me, but it's what you're supposed to tell people, right? You should just try your best to focus on all your other precious kitties. We need all your love and attention.
Yes. Yes. My darlings need me. Bless you for being such a sweetheart, dear. I'm sorry for your loss also. I hope you find peace.
Thank you. You too. Poor old soul. Next day.
Well, I'd get them all to wear the pink ones. But maybe lose the tiaras, because that's a bit much, don't you think?
Niari! My God.
Yeah, you don't want to overdo it and wind up looking like skanks instead of pretty princesses.
Niari!
Wait, how much are they? Jeez! Does that other place not do them cheaper?
Niari!
Oh, shit. Hang on a sec. Yeah. I see.
Okay.
Niari.
Oh, God.
Y'all.
No. Now, Niari.
What's the matter, boss?
Terminate that call, please.
I'm with the client.
No, you're not. Terminate the call. Now.
I'm so sorry, caller. My manager is instructing me to terminate this call. Would you be able to hold on for just one second? Seriously, what is your problem, huh?
You are not allowed personal calls. How many times do I have to tell you?
Oh gosh, yeah,
Niari. The helpline, so
Niari.
Yes, to moan about bridesmaids' dresses. That is hardly someone in crisis, is it?
Gosh darn it.
She's very upset about it, actually. It's a big decision.
I mean, yeah, kind of, but goddammit, Yari.
I remind you, then, that it is completely against the rules of this office to clog up the lines with personal calls and prevent...
Prevent what?
Lost, Kial. I'm working. Some of us are here to help people.
Nyari! Don't be rude.
Hello? Yeah, sorry about that. You were saying?
Put that phone down.
Nyari, you might want to listen.
Nah, I'd go for white shoes if I were you.
Nyari! For love of God! Where's Kiel going?
Yeah, well, they can wear their own at the reception anyways, can't they? Yeah. Yeah. What?
What's going on? Kiel, what are you doing to Nyari?
What are you doing, you maniac?
Kiel, what are you doing?
Put that fucking phone down. I won't tell you again.
Oh my god.
Are you for real? Did you guys see that? It was an assault. Psycho!
Nyari, no! Later that day. Oh my god.
Anyways, Kiel's been reported. But I bet they won't do anything, because it's bad for their image. They don't want anyone knowing the staff are more messed up than the folks calling in.
Seriously, Nyari, come on. Sounds about right.
How are you anyhow, newbie?
Holding in there. I think I'm alright. Just a bit shaken is all. So weird. Actually heard someone die.
Well, you didn't. You were busy singing kiddie rhymes. But I know what you mean.
Wait, what do you mean? You just feel so helpless, but... I suppose you gotta do what Tifa said and pull the shutters down. Honestly, don't know how you guys have coped for so long.
Ugh, Tava would say that. They've got so much ice up their ass, I sometimes call them Marana.
Wait, why? Why Marana? What's that a reference to? I don't get it.
That was supposed to be a joke.
Right, sorry.
You know, cause Marana is a deity of frost and death and stuff.
Ah, I see, yeah. I'm not sure Tava ever did anything to deserve a nickname like that. Sure, but it's probably just a coping mechanism or something. Right?
Mechanisms are for robots, Nine. And that's exactly what Tava is. I've never once seen them smile or make any kind of face, really, since they're always hiding behind that creepy freaking mask of theirs.
I think the mask is pretty hot, actually.
Hi, Nine. Hi, Nyari.
Oh, Tava! My beautiful, beautiful. Hi. Nyari sure changed the tune quickly there. Wonder if she ever talks about me like that when I'm not sat here.
How are you feeling, Nine?
A lot better now. Thanks.
Good. Best to put it behind you. It wasn't your fault.
Thanks, Tava. No matter how many times I tell myself that, it makes no difference whatsoever.
Here, I got you one of those drinks you like. I hope it's the right one.
Oh, did you get me coffee? What a sweet gesture. Thank you so much, Tava. Aww.
See? Complete asshole. Who is behind you? Tava couldn't care less.
Tava got me coffee! What are you talking about, Nyari? Pretty sure it's not like that, but I'm not about to argue with her.
Listen, the folks who ring here want a friend. They want to be told what to do. Doing nothing just makes it worse.
Look, they want someone to listen to them. They want someone to just vent. They don't. Sometimes people just don't want, like, some sort of help or, like, suggestions on what to do. They just want someone to listen to them because no one else will freaking listen to them, Nyari.
Like,
God damn it.
I had this dude on this morning whose wife had left him for her dead ex. She threw herself off a bridge to be with him and everything.
Yikes.
And Tava thinks I should just sit there and say nothing? Hell no! The guy was inconsolable, so I told him the afterlife is real, and he can get his revenge later. But for now, he should just forget about the bitch and live the rest of his life.
I can see why you, were unlikable by the rest of the staff, Nyari. That seems a bit much, and I thought we weren't supposed to reveal anything about the afterlife to people who aren't aware of it already.
And, because I was able to talk to him like a mate, I actually helped. He called back later this afternoon to say he'd quit his job and plans to travel the world sipping cocktails, living it up.
Sounds like you just pushed him to an early death. Maybe I've been doing things wrong. Nyari has been here for a while, after all. I could always try to take a leaf out of her book. I guess it all worked out in the end, then.
Exactly! Chalk another victory up to yours truly. I'm saving lives all over the place, newbie. Better watch and learn from the pro.
I really don't think that's the case.
Ooh, a video call. Nice. We don't get too many of those. The question is, will it be a hottie or a hag?
I don't care. It's a client. Let's just get to it. Whichever it is, at least this gets me out of that conversation. This is SSL. How can I help you today? Hello?
I've lost it.
Oh my god, you're hot! Ah! Lost what? Am I supposed to be a mind reader now? Actually, that'd be a pretty handy skill for an operator if SSL could find a telepath.
Everything.
Okay, well, do you want to talk about it?
All my partners left me. I've lost my job at the agency. Most of my friends are mocking me. I'm a mess. I don't know how I'm supposed to carry on like this.
I see. My god, you hottie. I'm really sorry to hear that. You're welcome to tell me all about what's bothering you.
Oh, I can't. It's too difficult for me to explain. Can I just show you instead?
Sure. That's not a problem. If you think it would help. I'm really not sure what I'm supposed to be looking at here. There isn't anything there. How did you lose it? Are you talking about your... You know...
Yes. At first, I just had problems getting it to stay up. But after a while, it just disappeared completely. It's kind of a major issue for an incubus.
I kind of understand. I can imagine. Though I prefer not to.
Well, what do you think the problem is?
I'm just gonna listen. I'm afraid I'm not exactly qualified to guess at things like that. Perhaps a doctor would be more of use.
Wait, you're not a doctor? I'm so sorry. I called the wrong number.
It's okay. You're cute. Come again!
That sounded like a fun one. Anyways, it's break time, newbie. Better hurry or all the best grub will be gone.
Yeah. What should I do next? Oh, God. All right, let's just go ahead and talk to a colleague. Honestly, I like Teva. I kind of want to like get to know Teva better, so I'm going to talk to Teva. Hey, yo, Teva. Maybe I should get to know Teva better. Hey, Teva. Would it be okay if I hang out with you for a bit?
Of course. Please, have a seat.
Thank you. It's just, well, I still don't really know anyone here properly, and you always seem to be alone, so I figured you might like some company.
While we appreciate the concern, Nine, you're mistaken. We are never alone.
Aw, we?
Indeed. Tava is a name chosen by majority vote. This body of ours plays host to several entities, all living together in harmony.
I got it. System.
When working... We refer to ourselves as I, so as not to confuse colleagues or callers. It also helps not to draw unnecessary attention to ourselves.
I see. But on your own time, it's better to just be yourselves, right?
Precisely.
Do you take your mask off too?
There is no need.
Huh. I see.
Does it trouble you, Nine?
Huh?
The obscurement of our face?
No, not at all. It's just, Yari was telling me about you before, and she said some pretty harsh stuff.
We detect you are being polite. An attempt to shield us from harm, perhaps? She would. It's in her nature to belittle those she's threatened by. What she lacks in intelligence, Yari makes up for with gossip and social status.
Yeah, definitely picked up on that. I'm sure she's a good person at heart, though.
That remains to be demonstrated, in our opinion. You would be wise not to get too close to that one, Nine. She'll only chew you up and spit you out when you're no longer of interest to her.
Whoa, have you guys always despised each other?
We do not despise anyone. We merely see greater value in some over others. Nyari is of very little value to us.
I see. And honestly, guys, if you're asking me, I like Teva. I like Teva a lot. How about me?
We shall have to see. You could prove a valuable member of the team here. Or you could simply be another average operator passing through.
Ouch!
Regardless, we will do our best to aid you, should you wish it.
Thanks, Tava. You're not all cold like Nyari claimed.
We merely prefer to keep to ourselves. We are always willing to help those that require it. Aside from cats, we refuse to associate with cats.
Oh gosh, I love you, Tava.
That was a joke.
Right. Well, see you around then. Well, what should I do next? I guess I'll just wait patiently. Later that night. Alright. I wonder where Nyari is this evening. It's unusual for her to be absent outside of break hours. Oh, not a call. Alright, let's pick up on that. Hello, this is SSL. Hello? Sorry, I didn't catch a word of that. I'm sorry, my translator seems to be broken. Could you repeat that for me one more time, please? Yeah, that's what I thought you said. What is going on right now? Are you having fun on your own? Oh my god, I think it did. Oh god, I think it was one of those calls. I have literally no idea what just happened. Ooh, all right. Hello, this is Sanctuary Support Line.
Is that really you?
I'm afraid you're going to have to elaborate.
It is you. You let me go. You knew, and you still let me go. Why?
I'm so sorry, but I have no idea what you're talking about. I think you might have the wrong number.
No, this is it. They told me you were there. I'm not crazy. I found you now, and I'm never letting you go. Because that's what best friends are supposed to do.
Best friends? Wait, Maddie? Maddie, is that you? Maddie!
You're in danger.
What do you mean? Maddie, please.
No! Get off of me! You don't understand anything! It'll kill us all!
Maddie? Maddie! What the heck is going on? I should call her back. I don't think we're allowed to do this, but... Oh, God.
The number you have reached is not in service. This is a recording. Please hang up and...
What? What is going on? What's that supposed to mean? My mind must be playing tricks on me. There's no way that could have been Maddie. I wish Nyari was here to talk. Next day. Well, this is day 3! Huh. Well. After falling asleep at my desk due to pure exhaustion, I awakened to an unpleasant nagging pain in my neck as I strained to look behind me and notice Nyari still isn't there. All I can do is hope that today will be better than yesterday. Here we go again. Hello, this is SSL. Hello? Hello? Oh. Oh!
Awesome. Look, I need to talk to you about something really important, Kay. So make sure you're listening properly.
I am all ears for you, baby. What's up? 20 minutes late. Oh, God. Oh, God. How long is this going for? Yeah. Man, she's still going.
So I saw her on Tuesday. No, Wednesday. Or wait, no, I think it was Tuesday. Because that's when me and Sophie went for coffee. And she came up to me and, like, actually stood in front of me and said, hiya.
Yeah?
But it wasn't her usual hiya. More like, hi, yeah. So then I was like, bitch, what's your problem?
Oh, God. Okay, and what did she say?
Oh, no. I didn't actually call her a bitch out loud. That's just what I was thinking at the time, because her hiya was just so strange, you know?
Yeah, I know, right?
So, like, Sophie said hi back, but I could tell the bitch was plotting some epic kind of, like, prank or something.
I see.
Like, that bitch is the whole reason I have to use a filter just to talk to people at, like, work meetings and stuff.
What do you mean by that?
Okay. What did she do to you?
Bitch shaved off all my damn fur when we last hung out and got drunk.
What? No way! That sounds rough.
Like, I don't care how funny she thought it was. You don't mess with a werewolf's fur. You just don't, right? Look at this shit.
You look adorable. I like you.
I actually don't. It's too freaking embarrassing.
You're adorable. Oh yeah, of course. Everyone knows that.
Exactly. So like, now I'm stuck fucking bald and shit while I wait for it all to grow back. If I don't use a damn filter, I'll get fired for sitting there freaking naked. Ain't nobody needs to see that shit while they're working.
Yeah,
and
I guess.
How am I supposed to meet anyone like this, huh? Like, what self-respecting wolf is gonna want to date a wolf with no fur?
I would smash a wolf with no fur. I would smash a wolf with fur. I would smash all the wolves. Smash all wolves without any discrimination. I would smash all of them.
It's a cruel fucking joke. And she's a cruel fucking bitch. I'm telling ya. I swear someday I'm gonna end her.
I see. Well, I'm just gonna listen. Alright, so what did you end up saying to her?
Huh? I didn't say anything. I just growled and spat on the bitch. Gotta go.
Alright, fair enough. Man, I hope they got their thing sorted out. I mean, releasing a small sigh of despair, I'm about to kick back and stretch when I spot Manager Keel heading my direction with a new recruit in tow.
Nine, is everything alright?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, well, keep up the good work. I know it's a tough job, but you've just got to hang in there. The devil makes work for idle hands, after all, and believe me, you do not want to be stuck doing the devil's work. It's much more pleasant here.
I like your words, funny man. Alright. Thanks, Keel. I'll keep that in mind.
Speaking of which, I've got to go and talk to the admins about recent events involving me and Nyari, so I wonder if you'd do me a small favor and take Yubel here through his induction. Yubel?
Sure thing. I'm hardly qualified to do something like that, but I can't exactly object to a direct request from the manager either.
Yubel, this is Nine. Nine's going to sit in on your first call and help you get acclimated.
Pleased to meet you.
Oh my god, you sound cute! You too!
Yubel's just transferred from our Pearly Gates office, so he already knows the basics. Now, I shouldn't be too long, but you can always ask Tava if you need any help.
Sure thing, yeah. So there are other offices just like this one. Kind of figure everything was handled here, but I suppose it's pretty small. It makes sense they need other branches. Ah, you cutie! Ah! Have you got enough room to squeeze in there? I know it's pretty cozy. Sorry.
I think so.
Ah, if you need to use the toilet, I'd go now before you get settled in. There's nothing worse than being stuck busting to go when you're in the middle of a long call. Try my best to make him feel welcome, but my little joke appears to do nothing to ease his awkwardness.
I'm alright. Thanks.
Can I smooch him right now? It can be quite harrowing.
Yeah, especially if it's a number two.
I meant some of the calls.
Right. Yeah. But we don't say anything, do we?
Well, that depends on who you ask. I'm sure Nyari would disagree. Well, not nothing, but it's important not to get too involved. I've been told you can't let your emotions get in the way.
Shall I?
Yeah, sure. Go right ahead. Do it.
Hello? Sanctuary support line?
You're doing great! Doing great!
Do you want to talk?
I think so. What's your name?
Wait! That's Mallory!
I'm Ubel. Do you want to tell me your name? You don't have to.
It's Mallory.
Oh god. Can't be. There's no way it's the same person, right?
Hi, Mallory. What's on your mind today?
Oh, just... I hate my life. I hate my mom. I hate my stepdad.
Why would he lie?
My stepdad.
Why would he lie? No way. It is them.
Just a second, Mallory. Did I do it wrong?
No, you didn't. Just keep going. Let's not jump to any conclusions. I'll just have to wait and see what they say.
Sorry about that, Mallory. How long have you felt like this?
Oh, too long now. I don't think I can carry on anymore.
What sort of sick joke is this?
Well, it's never too late to change your life around.
It might be. I've taken some tablets.
I have to think of something. Can't let poor Ubel go through what I did.
What? You've taken some tablets? How many, Mallory?
What is this? Some kind of twisted prank?
30? Maybe 40?
Okay, well, the thing to do is stay calm.
I'll be kind. Listen, Mallory, you can't keep doing this. I don't know why it is that you feel the need to call this helpline acting like this, but it's not right.
But I've taken some tablets.
There's no way I'm falling for that again. I have to be firm but fair. That's what you said last time too. If there's something you genuinely want to talk about, I'm here to listen. If you think this is some kind of joke, it's really not funny in the slightest.
What do you mean?
Every minute you're sat on the line messing me about, there could be someone out there who's really dying. Someone who desperately needs our help. You can understand that, right? Mallory, is everything okay? Sorry if that sounded a little harsh, but you can talk to me if you need to.
No, it's all right. I just wanted you to sing me a song, was all.
Well, if I wasn't working, maybe I would. Hey, why don't you try singing something yourself? I bet you're a great singer.
I guess.
Did you want to talk about anything else, Mallory?
No, I'm okay. Thank you, Nine. You're a good person.
Ah, damn. My little Mallory. Gosh darn it.
Well, that was a bit of an odd one. Thanks for stepping in there. Sounds like they had a thing for you, huh?
Likely. I don't know. I sure hope not. I mean, I wish so, but still. Later that day. I guess this is another moment where I can, like, check the computer if I like. This gathering is pretty ominous. I'm guessing it's something to do with the incident between Nyari and Manager Keel. Nyari wouldn't stop talking about it. I think she wants to get me on her side as a witness, but since I didn't actually see any of it happen, I couldn't exactly take her account events as gospel. I just hope that everything will work out between them.
Now, as you may know by now, I am not one for speeches. I'm more of a listener. I don't like saying goodbyes either, especially after so many years of service.
No! No way. The admins tell Kiel to leave? Glancing around at everyone's faces, I can discern nothing from the anxious expressions.
We've had our ups and downs in this office. I like to think I was always fair, but none of us can ignore the powers that be and the recommendations that they've made.
This is it. Kiel's toast. Wonder who they'll bring in as a new manager.
So it is with great sadness that we have to see Nyari go. I don't know if you want to say a few words, Nyari?
Yeah! Oh, man! So they took the manager's side instead. Figures. It's always the ones lower down the ladder that bear the brunt of these decisions, even in a place like this. Another reason for me to just do my time and keep my head down like Teva told me to. Suddenly, Nyari stands to the sounds of mixed murmuring, lacking some of the usual enthusiasm in her movements, as I watch her expression change from one of irritation to one of fondness.
Well, I'm sure it's more than obvious I don't want to go. But I've been, let's just say, politely encouraged to move on to another department.
The office drama, I swear to God. Her eyes shift towards Kiel, a slight bitterness in her tone that sounds even more biting than her usual harmless jibes.
I'll miss some of you. You know who you are.
Shooting me a sideways glance, she smiles warmly. I can't help but be somewhat surprised she'd think of me that way when we haven't known each other all that long.
And I'll miss helping folks even more. Because that's all I ever did. And if that's not what you're supposed to do here, then I'm sorry.
You were gossiping, Nyari. What the heck? For the first time, I witnessed her almost speechless. Part of my heart sinks when I notice how hard she swallows, attempting to contain her emotions.
Anyways, I bought a bottle of bubbly, so have a little drink on me. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers! Kanpai! Whatever.
As the room erupts in a chorus of clapping, Kale seems somewhat flustered, awaiting quiet to fall upon the office once more.
But let's not forget why we're here. There are lots of people out there that need us tonight, so be sensible, please. You're welcome to see her off, just don't go mad.
Alright. With hands clasped firmly together, Kale bows down before making a swift exit, leaving Nyari to scooch up beside me. When she holds out a small piece of paper, I fail to hide my confusion.
I know you probably won't, but if you ever want to call me, this is my number.
Sure. Taken aback by her heartfelt gesture, I struggle to find the right words to say. Thank you so much, Nyari. I'll have to give you mine.
That's alright. I know where you are.
A wink at me playfully, Nyari's sunny side returns and she wanders off to pour drinks for everyone. I will stay and socialize. I guess I should socialize with my colleagues. Who should I talk to? Honestly, I feel like I should talk with Nyari because she's about to go. I would love to talk with Teva more, but at least I could do is, you know, talk with Nyari. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'd like to spend more time with Nyari before she leaves. Hey, Nyari, do you mind if we chat a little before you have to go?
Of course. You don't need to ask, silly. I was gonna come talk to you anyways. Let me just finish pouring these drinks, and then I'm all yours.
In what way? Oh. Huh.
That's everyone sorted, I think. So, was there anything in particular you wanted to say?
Actually, there was one thing I was hoping to ask.
Well, go on then, spit it out already. Don't you know it's rude to keep a girl waiting?
Please don't take this the wrong way, but I never did get to touch your ears.
Oh boy. Please don't tell me that's all you were thinking of every time we spoke, because I could have sworn you were looking at me funny.
Oh, I'm looking you real funny. I love your collar, by the way. No, that's just my face. My face is very funny. Thank you very much.
Yeesh. Unlucky newbie. I guess not everyone can be blessed with looks like mine.
Exactly. Exactly. Anyway, thanks. I've been curious ever since you offered.
Aw, sorry about that. I mean, I would let you, but Kiel's probably watching me like a hawk right now. The last thing I want is more trouble from that creep before I go, you know?
Yeah, I getcha. Right, no worries. I totally understand.
Hey, you've always got my number, though, and you can call me anytime, okay?
Yeah,
heck,
totes.
Maybe when you're free, we should meet up for a drink or something. I'll let you pet me all you like outside of the office.
Oh my, I'ma pet you real hard, Nyari. Oh gosh, sounds like a plan.
I guess I better mingle before folks think I've already left. See you around, newbie.
Alright, see you, Nyari.
You can touch me all you like, darling.
Sure! Thanks for the offer, but rather not.
What? You'd rather put your hands all over that filthy fur wall than feel some of the smoothest scales in all known dimensions of the universe?
I want to touch all of you. I mean, consensually, of course. Well, yeah, actually, fur feels nice. Snakes are all slimy. No, they're not! Snakes are the greatest pet in the world!
How dare you? Your ignorance astounds me, darling. Color me insulted.
Yeah?
For one, I am not a snake. That's a derogatory term for my kind, and should have faded from use eons ago. Alas, we are persecuted for our uncanny likeness to those primitive creatures.
Hey, they make amazing pets, by the way.
And, for your information, serpents are not even remotely slimy, which you'd know if you just came a little closer.
Oh, I'ma come really close, Niart. Ooh, yes. I'm sorry, Niart. I didn't know that. Still, I'm fine where I am, thank you.
Well, if you're truly sorry, you can make it up to me with a dance.
I'm not that sorry.
Nonsense, newbie. Come, let us dance the night away in a lover's embrace.
Can I say yes? Teva, anyone, please save me. Oh man, what should I do next? And I guess I'll just wait. Like heck, there ain't much else to do. There we go. This is SSL, how can I help you?
I can't take it anymore. I have to quit my job. I just have to.
I'm sorry to hear that. What's make you feel that way?
Well, I'm a Reaper, you see, but
the dead, they just... they creep me out so much.
Look, I mean, it's not your fault, okay? Like, humanity has taken a huge change. We no longer fear death. We crave death. We need death. And if you think that I meant that, okay, people want to die, no. We just want death. All right, let's just keep going.
If I have to hold hands with another corpse, I think I might puke my damn guts up.
That certainly doesn't sound ideal.
I know, right? So I should just quit then, don't you think?
I'm just gonna listen. Oh dear.
You know what? This isn't your problem. I'm sorry. I never should have bothered you with this. Good day, operator.
Yeah, good day. Hope you have a nice day. Gosh darn, so many different problems. I'm tired. Thankfully, it's my last day, I guess. Later that night. All right. I know things might have calmed down now, but I can't believe Niari is still listening out for her phone on the night she's leaving. Her dedication is pretty damn admirable.
Hello, Sanctuary Support Line. How can I help you? 9? Sure. I'll just put you through. Newbie, it's for you!
Oh, thanks, Niari. For me? Weird. Hello?
I've taken some tablets.
Oh, gosh darn it, Mallory! Ah, this nuisance again. I thought it was clear enough last time, but it seems as though they still didn't get the message. I don't know why I didn't just report it to Kiel to see if we could get the number blocked or something. What do you want, Mallory?
I just wanted to say sorry. I didn't mean to upset you last time.
Well, this is new. You haven't upset me. In fact, I feel sorry for you. You need help.
That's why I'm calling a helpline.
I'll be forgiving. Sorry, I didn't mean to snap at you. It's just, you know, I've told you before not to call this number unless you actually need help.
And I told you that I do. Somebody's not a great listener.
Excuse me! Please, Mallory, it's been a long day. If you've just called to taunt me, stop. If you want to talk, I'll listen.
Oh? And what would you do if I did just call to taunt you? Are you going to hunt me down and punish me for being a bad, bad boy?
Oh, I'ma punish you real good, Mallory. You have no idea what I'm capable of. Isn't that right, Blaha? Isn't that right, Blaha? All right. That's it. I'm cutting you off. Sorry. Great. I really screwed that one up. I don't know why I'm still letting them get to me. It's just a stupid troll. Snatching up the phone, I remain silent this time, waiting for whoever is on the other end to speak.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Stop it.
How I wonder what you are.
Stop it, Mallory.
Up above the world so high.
Right. I'm gonna put you on to my colleague. Having had more than enough, I decided it's best to let Niari handle this since she has so much more experience than I am. She must know of a better way to deal with callers like this.
No! I won't speak to anyone else. I only want to talk to you.
Luck appears to be on Mallory's side since when I turned to ask for Niari's aid, she's nowhere to be seen. Listen, Mallory. I need you to understand something. I am not your friend, okay? I'm here to listen and sometimes give guidance, but that is where my job ends. I'm not here by choice, so just want you to leave me alone, please.
But you've been so patient with me, Nine. You even sang me a song. Only a true friend would do something like that.
Well, I guess.
I'm your friend too, you know? I just want to help you.
What do you mean by that? What are you talking about? I don't need your help.
You do, Nine. Trust me. Do you think they're just going to let you leave once you've done your time? Don't be so naive. You'll be stuck working away for eternity, just as an obedient little slave. They can do that, you know. Keep you alive for as long as they want.
Yikes. How do you know about any of this?
Are you having a party? I might come along. I know where you are.
Oh my god, I have a stalker! Nice! Lovely! Eyes darting desperately around the office, I search for even the slightest hint of suspiciousness among my colleagues, but everyone seems to be casually enjoying Nyari's leaving, do. Am I going insane? I guess there's no time to dwell on it.
I have to make a report to the manager or something if it keeps up, though. SSL, how are you today?
So hungry.
You're hungry? Is this a joke?
No. Please help me. I'm starving.
Okay, well, I can't exactly bring you food.
Oh, but you can, my dear. You know, your voice is quite delightful.
Wait, isn't this... Nerd? I forgot his name. Thanks, I guess?
Feels good, doesn't it? Now you try. Well?
Nerd? Is that you?
Why, whatever makes you say that? I know not of this Nyhar that you speak of. I am but a humble stranger in need of your assistance, who also happens to be quite hungry.
Well, Nyhar, if you needed me to, like, feed you, I could feed you. I recognize your voice, idiot.
Do you insult all of our clients, Nine? Or is that barbed tongue reserved exclusively for yours truly?
Oh my god, is this your kink, Nyhar? It depends.
Not very talkative tonight, are we? Look, if you just pay me one easy-weensy compliment, then I'll leave you alone. How's that for a deal?
You do realize I could just hang up on you, right?
You wouldn't dare. Besides, I'd simply call you back. Again, and again, and again.
Nyhar, please, no! Wanna bet?
Oh, hush. I scarcely have the energy to play with you.
So, what you're saying is, I could just wait on the line until you starve to death.
Please don't test me, darling. I'm positively famished.
Oh no! I got a choice of compliment or insult! Oh man, I mean, I know this is your cake, but actually, I want to see what happens if I insult. I want to see what happens if I insult! Oh my god! And to think, I wonder why Acherus disliked you so much.
Oh, please don't mention that monster's name. On the verge of collapsing here, I need sustenance, not sarcasm.
Good. I hope you starve, Snake.
Heartless harpy. I swear to you, I will not forget this insolence.
Bye, Nyhar. I have no freaking clue. Oh, man. I will answer. Swallowing my fears, I pick up the phone. Hello, SSL.
Oh, thank goodness you picked up. I'm in quite the quandary, you see.
Oh, yes. What's the problem, dear sir?
I've gone cold turkey, but I crave it oh so much. It's like my insides are on fire.
Are you able to tell me what is it that you're craving?
Yes, of course. It's that sweetest of nectars, blood. I'm a vampire, you see, so I'm just so tired of stealing it from innocent humans. And I tried to extract it from animals instead, but it's not the same. I don't want to harm a single living creature again. I refuse to become a slave to my hunger like so many others.
That does sound quite problematic. Won't you die if you don't drink?
Precisely. Although, vampiric death isn't entirely the same as other kinds of passing, since we're technically already long dead anyway. I've heard it's excruciating.
I can imagine. It seems like you're not left with much of a choice, though.
Why do you think I'm calling? There must be something you can say to make me feel better, at least. I thought this was supposed to be a support line. Can you help me or not?
I'm just here to listen. I'm not gonna ask him to drink children! No! Huh! Sorry, we're just supposed to offer active listening rather than advice here.
Well, then what bloody use are you to anyone? I should drain you dry just for wasting my time!
Oh man, like, I know like most people would be terrified in this situation, but I just find this hilarious. Goodbye, good sir! Sheesh, what a temper. So busy tonight. You've reached SSL, can I help you?
Hello, Nine.
I go to turn instinctively, but freeze when I feel the cold breath of a stranger brush against my throat.
Keep facing forward.
I want to watch the replay later.
Eyes fixed on my monitor. I try to identify my attacker in the reflection on the screen when a stabbing pain erupts from my neck.
You're no longer amusing, I'm afraid. It's time for me to find a new toy. Maybe that poor Pearly Gates boy will do.
Ah! I didn't even hear anything! Incident Report 03, Snuff Film. Nine was murdered before uncovering Mallory's true identity. What? Crime Report 01, Tabitha the Witch. Left to figure things out on her own, Tabitha decided to stop practicing magic altogether, choosing instead to take over a zoo her dad used to run in an attempt to overcome her fear of all creatures, great and small. Crime Report 02, Allie the Alligator. Following Allie's call with Nine, Allie and his wife became even more distant until one day she simply left without a word. Allie still regularly collects coupons. Clan Report 03, Cat Lady. After speaking of Nine, the old cat lady was eventually able to come to terms with losing Baldrick, thanks to Nine's kind words and the company of her other kitties. She was so thankful for Nine's advice that she updated her will to give 10% of her estate to SSL instead of 100% to a local cat charity. Clan Report 04, Romeo the Incubus. After hanging up in a hurry, Romeo immediately booked an appointment with a real doctor. However, the doctor could find nothing physically wrong with the incubus, and so Romeo remained searching for a way to restore his vanished manhood. Crime Report 05, Reiko the Werewolf. Wallowing in hatred, Reiko made a point of stalking her nemesis until she was caught, arrested, and charged with indecent exposure. Crime Report 06, Remy the Reaper. Deciding to tackle a disgust head-on, Remy invested in several pieces of equipment to try and make her job easier. Ultimately, it was the thick pair of gloves that she purchased, which came in most handy when hauling the dead to the afterlife. Clan Port 07, Dirk the Vampire. Dirk was so furious at Nine's refusal to give advice that his last string of sanity snapped, causing Dirk to become consumed by his bloodlust. Blinded by a crimson haze, the blood-crazed vampire made a terrible mistake, wandering into limbo in search of Nine, where he was immediately incarcerated before being sent to hell. I'm going for the good ending. We did not come this far just to lose.
I'm gonna ignore and investigate. And what answer? What if it's Mallory again? No. Can't just sit here cowering in fear because of some creep. Whoever it was, they know about the stuff that's been happening here, which means it has to be someone who works here. With anxiety trembling incessantly in my stomach, I make my way towards Manager Keel's office. This whole building has security cameras. If I can search through the records, I can find out who is playing such a cruel prank on me. It's probably just some stupid initiation joke, but still. Making sure to be extra stealthy, I throw myself down at the manager's desk, a half grin on my face as I realize the PC in front of me is already on and unlocked. Pretty careless for someone so intent on sticking to all the rules. I'm sure Kiel would have a few words to say about this, but Kiel isn't here to help. I have no choice but to do some digging myself. Just as I'm about to start searching through the footage, something flits past the window, causing me to freeze in my tracks. What was that? Peering cautiously through the small window into the corridor, I realize whoever it was must have entered the main office already. It had to be Mallory. Who else would be here so late? Stealing myself, I decide to try again and gain the upper hand by catching my stalker in the act. This butthole thinks they can mess with me. Let's see how they like it when I play them at their own game. Heart in my throat, I pick up the phone on Kiel's desk and dial the number for SSL while keeping my gaze firmly fixed on the camera feed from my booth.
SSL?
Teva? Hello, Mallory. This is it. I've caught the guy in the act. Now I need to call for backup.
Sorry?
Don't act so surprised. What are you doing here?
I forgot my bag. Is that you, Nine?
Staring at the figure sat at my desk, I can just about make out the mask covering its face. Teva. Yeah, I'm over in the manager's office.
Why? You do realize Kyo will lose it if there's any trace you've been in there.
At this point, I honestly don't care. I need to get to the bottom of this. That's all that matters. Mallory knew we were having some sort of party tonight. It had to be someone in this office, and... Oh, look. You turn up.
Yes, to get my bag. Who's Mallory?
Playing innocent won't save you now, Teva. You can drop the act, Teva. Got the time codes. I'm going to find the footage of you calling me as Mallory, and then I'm contacting the police.
Nine, I don't know what you're...
Before Teva can finish the sentence, I cut them off, fueled by a mixture of adrenaline and nerves. Tapping furiously on Kiel's computer, I search for the corresponding footage. When Teva burst through the door, an air of concern about them.
Listen, I don't know what you think I've done, but I swear I don't know anyone called Mallory. From where I'm standing, you're the suspicious-looking one, skulking around in the dark like that.
Refusing to even face Teva, I keep my eyes glued to Kiel's monitor when a gentle hand comes to rest on my shoulder.
The security feed will prove my innocence, so will you at least let me help you search?
Fine. Gritting my teeth, I continue to avoid glancing at Teva as I fast forward through the recording of the last few days. There! This one's of Teva!
It's just... if I lose the goat, then that's it! It's all gone! They're all I have left!
Okay.
Huh.
She won't do it. I know she won't. It would be too cruel even for her. It's not even worth... Oh, Satan, I don't know. I tell her brothers and... the bag. I can't.
Hmm. See? No Mallory. Just a poor old man. He called because his daughter was trying to take over the farm they shared in Purgatory. Demon goats are a valuable commodity there. But for him, it wasn't just about the money. They were his world.
Man, a man and his goats. I can see it. Demon goats. Fair enough.
What about this one from Nyari's booth? It has the same timestamp.
Wait, what? What's this? Surely Nyari wouldn't do something like that. She seems so nice. Then again, there's all that stuff behind Teva's back. Who knows what she really thought about me? I suppose I shouldn't discount it. For God's sake!
Let me guess. Another masturbator? Filthy animals need to find a new fetish already, if you ask me. Right! I'm off. I've got a hot date with a tuna steak.
I see. Wait. You can leave?
Perks of loyal service, my friend. Stick at it, and maybe one day you'll reach my level. Enjoy the night shift, newbie.
Huh. Wait, also Nyari wasn't around during the calls. Hello, SSL? Right, so it wasn't Nyari either.
As much as I would have loved it to be her, it seems as though she's innocent too. Which leaves... how about this one? You could try it and see.
Sure thing. Surely Teva's not suggesting, but I suppose everyone here is a suspect.
Will you sing to me?
No! No! I'm sure. Not very good at it, but I'll give it a go. What do you want to hear?
Well, I like a lot of ballads, but I think they might be a bit long. Do you know any children's rhymes or lullabies?
That's right. They can change their voice. You mean like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star?
Yeah.
Okay, I think I know most of it. Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. I can't. Oh God. God damn. It was Kiel. They've got a major kick. Ah. God damn. So in my booth, I'm thankful there's been a quiet morning. There's no way I can concentrate on helping everyone when I know what I do now. Manager Kiel needs to be exposed. I just have to figure out the right timing.
Nine, could you come to my office, please? I need to speak to you urgently regarding your assessment.
Sure. God damn it. That's it. Game over. I'm totally and utterly screwed. Assessment my butt. Kiel's gonna kill me. No, I can't think like that. Teva and I put everything back where we found it. Kiel should have no idea we were even in the manager's office, let alone snooping around checking out the camera footage. I just have to play it cool. That's it. Stay calm. It's been 4 days. If Kiel truly wants to discuss my assessment results, I could potentially be out of here soon, safe and sound. Oh God. Fighting back my worst fears, I marched towards the manager's office.
There you are. What's with that stern face, Nine? There's no need to worry. It's good news.
What's up? It is? Oh, that's a relief. For a moment, I was convinced Kiel headed in for me.
Of course. What were you expecting?
Death?
I don't know. It's difficult to look the manager in the eye knowing what I know now. Kiel's friendly demeanor is just so odd with the harassing nature of Mallory. If I hadn't seen the footage myself, I'm not even sure I believe it was the same person.
I've finished assessing your case, and I'm pleased to inform you that your time with us is now at an end. Your sentence is served, Nine. You may go home now if that's what you desire.
Of course, thank you.
You are also more than welcome to remain here as long as you abide by the rules. The choice is yours.
So that's it? I can put this place behind me? Leave, head home, and pretend as though none of this happened? I have to admit, the idea of going back to my normal life, it holds a certain appeal, but can I really just forget about this place? Okay, we're gonna go home first, and then we're gonna see what happens if we stay. Alright, I should probably just get out of here while I still can. That's amazing news! I was worried I would wind up taking longer, since the administration mentioned it potentially takes up to a year. Try my best to appear calm and casual, I breathe a sigh of relief, flashing Kiel a grin.
That old trick. It's nonsense, Nine. We never take that long to assess anyone. That's just the administrator's way of messing with the fresh meat.
Yeah, I see. Oh, well, you sure fooled me. Anyway, I think I'd like to go home. My time here has been interesting, but I don't think it's really for me.
Well, then, your ordeal is over. You should consider yourself lucky, Nine. Some of us are stuck here.
Yeah, really lucky. Seemingly struck by a sudden sense of melancholy, Kiel's gaze drops to the floor for a moment.
But that's hardly your problem now, is it? Let's get you back where you belong.
Thanks, Kiel. And then, just as swiftly, Kiel's typical half-smile returns, though slightly more forced than usual. Do I need to sign some paperwork or anything like that?
No. Everything's already been taken care of. If you follow me, I could send you straight home.
Oh god, this is bad. Gingerly step into Kiel's office and take one last look behind me at the unremarkable office space, bidding it a silent farewell.
It's just through here.
Oh no. Usher me forward towards the door at the back of manager's office. I'm about to open it when a hand comes to rest my shoulder, causing me to spin on the spot.
Allow me to congratulate you before you go, Nine.
Offering me a hand, I take it, wincing slightly as one of Kiel's clawed fingers scratches against my wrist while he performs a firm handshake. Good luck with everything.
Indeed, I shall undoubtedly need it. Safe travels.
Forcing a fake smile onto my face, I make my way through the door. Slight apprehension gripping me as I swiftly swallow by the unsettling darkness on the other side. You sure this is the right way?
Oh yes, quite sure.
Pretty sure it's not. Furrowing my brow, I'm about to turn and face Kiel once again when the door slams shut behind me. Kiel?
Yes, Nine?
Kiel, what's going on? Do I just keep walking?
You could certainly try.
What's that supposed to mean? Taking a deep breath, I proceed forward, only to trip over something on the ground, stumbling into what feels like a wall. A faint sound of laughter penetrates the door, filling the room as well as my heart with dread.
What's that, Nine? There are all sorts of skeletons in my closet.
Oh no. Please tell me that was meant figuratively. Crouching down, I hold one hand out in front of me, shuddering when my fingers graze a surface similar to bone. In a state of panic, I march back up to the door, banging hard against it. Kiel, this isn't funny! Let me out!
Oh? And what if I disagree? You have to admit it's at least a little bit funny.
How is this funny? It really isn't!
But you want to know what the biggest joke of all is, Nine.
What is it? I really don't!
My f***ing life. Being manager of this miserable place, listening to other people's problems all day, every day, sucking up admin, endless meetings with idiotic bureaucrats.
Jesus Christ.
This is my own personal hell, Nine. Eternal damnation.
Oh, I get it. It's the nine circles of hell. That's where my name comes from. Despite the harassment I've endured at the manager's hands as Mallory, I still feel an ounce of pity for Kiel's situation. I'm sorry, I really am, but keeping me here isn't gonna make things better.
That's where you're wrong. You're kind, Nine. Not like the others. No matter what I said, you still listen to me. You're everything I need. Everything I crave. If I keep you here, with me, I'll never be lonely again.
What?
Please, Kyo, I just want to go home.
No. If I can never leave, neither can you. Now, I'm in charge here, so I'm going to tell you exactly what's going to happen.
What's going to happen?
You're going to stay in that room like a good little listener. No one's going to miss a random human.
Kyo, no!
After everything I've been through, after all the calls I've answered, I deserve this. I work so, so hard.
You're insane!
It's my turn to talk now, Nine. You will listen to me. Soon, my voice will become all you know. My words, your world. So you better make yourself comfortable, Nine. We're going to be here for quite a while.
Kyo, no! Ah, frick! God damn it! Alright, this time I'm gonna choose to stay. There's nothing waiting for me at home, so I might as well stay here for the time being. Actually, I think I might just stay here if that's alright with you, manager. Besides, if I hang around, I'm bound to find an opportunity to expose Kyo at some point. I want to be here to watch the expression on the manager's face when confronted by admin.
Excellent choice, Nine. In that case, allow me to congratulate you on becoming a fully-fledged member of SSL.
Offering me a brief handshake and a bright grin, Kyo seems suspiciously cheerful. Thanks. Cautiously, I shake Kyo's hand and return my courteous smile.
You're a good listener, Nine. One of the best we've had. We should grab a drink together sometime. I could really use someone with your skills. Now, better get back to your station.
Thanks, Kyo. You need therapy more like. It's what I wish I could say out loud. Whatever problems Kyo has, they require the ear of a professional. Sure. Plodding back to my booth after such a surprisingly uneventful meeting, a smirk of contentment spreads across my face. I throw myself down into my chair, clasping my hands together. It's time to start plotting Kiel's downfall. Huh? Hi there, Sanctuary Support Line. How can I help you today? Ascendancy Report. Nine remained at SSL and eventually exposed Kyo's many years of harassment calls to other staff, prompting admin to promote Nine to become the new office manager. Nice! Nine reappointed Nyari, located Maddie, and requested that admin allow weekly counseling sessions for every operator to help with the stress of the job. Kyo was sentenced to dwell within the forgotten color of limbo. Driven mad by the state of perpetual isolation, Kyo began role-playing support calls all alone. Oh my god! Huh! Limbo Line was made in 1 month for Spooktober VN Jam. No way! We hope you enjoyed your time at SSL. Anyway, that was Limbo Line. Thank you all so much for watching. I really hope you guys enjoyed this. This was another really long episode, so thank you all so much for sticking around for this long. Anyway, if you guys want to play this game for yourself, link to game will be in the description below, alongside all the other fun links like Discord, so on and so forth. And yeah, I hope you all have a lovely rest of the day, and I'll be seeing you in the next video. This is Lionel, signing off. Ciao.